Oh, what's up guys, how do you do? Welcome to today's edition of Programming Wizards TV. In this class, we're going to see how to actually query an XML from LINQ in vb.net. Okay, so let's go start right here. First, we're going to add three imports: import system, imports system.link, imports system.xml.link. Then we'll come and create our module. We call it module one. Then the first thing is that we're going to create this function that we're calling getXML. Now this we're going to get XML and then of course return it right here. Okay, so get XML as XML element. So sorry, as X element. It is this X element which is the return type of these space shuttles that we are returning in this function. So first what we're going to do is that we're going to create the space shuttles right at the variable. Okay, so dim space shuttles as X element, then we'll come of course give it an XML. VB in vb.net we can actually write our XML literally, as you can see right here. For example, you can see space shuttles, we open it and then close it as the parent tag. Then we come and have the space shuttle right here. So this is space shuttles to encapsulate all our space shuttles. Then a single space shuttle, then of course the name of the space shuttle, in this case Columbia, then the propellant, in this case chemical. Then you can proceed and add of course the other more space shuttles, okay, as you can see right here. So having done that one, of course you are returning the space shuttles using the return statement. Then having done that one, we'll come and then create our main subroutine. So sub main, then end sub. Then we'll come right here and have dim chemical powered space shuttles. What you want to do is that you want to query this XML to return the space shuttles that are powered by chemical as the propellant. So from space shuttle in getXML.elements, then space shuttle, we come where space shuttle.element, then we pass in the propellant equal to chemical. Okay, then space shuttle.element name, be selecting the names. And then when we selected them, we're going to come and loop through them. So for each name in chemical powered space shuttles, console.write line, then name.value, then of course console.read line. So that's all we need to do. Then we click the start button to run our project. And if we run the project, as you guys can see, it has actually selected via the LINQ. Okay, so it's selected for us the space shuttles that are powered by the chemical. First we have the Columbia, then we have the Endeavour, we have the Apollo, and then we have the Pioneer. In fact, if we come to our space shuttles XML, you can see that indeed those are the ones that are powered by chemical. We can see Columbia, then we have the Endeavour, then we have also the Apollo right here. Okay, so those are the ones powered by, and of course the Pioneer. So that's it guys, like this video, share it, and make sure you guys subscribe to our channel Programming Users TV, and take care. I'll catch you in the next class.